It's been a few weeks since I bought Samsung Galaxy's S24 Ultra, and using it every day in lots of different scenarios and environments, I have to say that this phone continues to surprise and impress me as a first-time Samsung phone owner. The incredible display, titanium design, snappy performance, and of course, the incredible cameras are all reasons I love this phone. So I'll go over my experience with the Galaxy S24 Ultra after 2 to 3 weeks of daily use, and as much as I love this phone, I don't think it's for everyone. So let's start with the things I've disliked. Number one is the shutter lag on the camera, and this is a big issue. The cameras itself are downright incredible. It's without a doubt the best mobile camera I've used yet, and I'll show you just how good it has been when I've taken it on trips and in daily use later in this video. But the shutter lag is a serious flaw in that camera system. Whenever I snap things in motion, things like animals, kids, cars, the subject is usually blurry more often than not, and I'm not even referring to super fast movements that require really high shutter speeds. I'm talking about slight movements where most rival phones like my iPhone 15 would nail the shot without breaking a sweat. And that's because of the shutter lag issue, the delay between pressing the shutter button and the camera actually capturing the photo. And there's a significant delay on the S24 Ultra. After some digging online, I realized that this is a proper issue with previous gen Samsung Galaxy phones, which is really surprising considering just how great of a camera it is for practically everything else outside of the shutter lag issue. The second thing I've disliked are the speakers. I found the speaker to sound strangely hollow, and I've noticed the lack of punch in its sound almost right away after unboxing the phone. For example, if I'm watching content with dialogue, it's sometimes drowned out by other cinematic sound effects, and it's tough to pick up what exactly they're saying. Same thing with music. Bass is lacking, highs and lows are slightly distorted. Unfortunately, I don't have previous Samsung Ultra phones to compare to since this is my very first one I own, but comparing it to my iPhone 15 Pro speakers, the S24 Ultra definitely lags behind in clarity and pure volume. Some of you guys suggested in the unboxing video to turn on the Dolby Atmos setting, which definitely helped improve the sound profile, and it does actually make a difference. But even with Dolby Atmos turned on, it doesn't quite stack up against the spatial audio speakers found on my iPhone 15 Pro. So next, I've really been enjoying Android 14 and the One UI operating system, more than I thought I would actually. The One UI is really good in many different ways. It's stable, has a refined Android interface, and there's tons of customization. There's stuff iPhone users don't get either, like Edge panels, a shortcut tab that lets me open favorite apps quickly, and Bixby call screening, which is sort of an automated voice assistant that takes calls for you. But here is the negative of the system, and maybe the most controversial. The biggest feature of the S24 Ultra, which is Galaxy AI, as well a paid subscription model. This fact was kept relatively low-key by Samsung. It wasn't really mentioned by them, but it's found in the footnotes on the US sales page. So Galaxy AI features will be provided for free until the end of 2025 on supported Samsung Galaxy devices. It seems like an industry trend to put AI features behind a paywall, unfortunately, but I just think it's a bit of a shame that Galaxy AI is an extended trial for owners in some ways. It's a tough pill to swallow when the price tag of this flagship phone is already quite steep. But speaking of Galaxy AI, this brings me onto what I love about the S24 Ultra as a first-time Samsung user, and buckle up because there's a lot that I love about this phone. So Galaxy AI has been properly useful day-to-day, and I've appreciated it just for how integrated it is on this phone. Live Translate AI is a great example of this. It translates phone calls in foreign languages in real time without having to do anything extra. I've used it plenty for real-time FaceTime calls with my Mandarin-speaking friends, and it's really incredible and genuinely useful. It works with any caller because it uses on-device processing, so the other person on the other line could be on any smartphone, landline, or even public phone, and Live Translate AI works a charm. There's even an option to mute my voice and the caller's voice, so we're speaking only through live translations, and I can easily manage a proper conversation in an entirely different language that I don't know how to speak. This one's a game changer, and it's an example of where I think Samsung is leaps ahead of Apple. Generative AI photo editing is also another AI feature I've been using and really enjoying. It's as easy as ever to reposition subjects in a photo, delete them out entirely, and even extend the entire photo thanks to generative AI. Turning any high resolution video into a slow motion video is also quite incredible too when it does actually work. What Galaxy AI does here is it reads the video frames in sequence and then adds AI generated frames in between to increase the overall frame rate of the video for that smooth video slow-mo look. It's just yet another example of a great and convenient AI feature. So for example, if you don't capture the video in 120 frames and you have a great shot that you actually want to slow down, you can now do that afterwards. A lot of these ideas aren't actually new ideas, and in fact, many Galaxy AI tools are essentially what Google is working on, like for example, circle to search function, which is already out on the Pixel 8 and the 8 Pro. But Samsung has done a great job integrating these AI features into the phone natively, and they perform really well considering that the S24 Ultra is powered by a Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 chipset, which is, I believe, the first mobile chipset to include generative AI on its silicon directly. The AI features are still in its early stages and has a lot of work to be done. For example, some AI features are even restricted to Samsung's own apps. But to be fair, like many other companies, Samsung is throwing things at the wall and seeing what sticks at the moment when it comes to AI, probably before they start to charge for it in 2025. Now, let's spend some time talking about the cameras, because outside of the shutter lag issue, this is my favorite mobile camera to date. So on the back, we have the primary 200 megapixel sensor, a 12 megapixel ultrawide sensor, two tele lenses, one with 10 megapixels and the other with 50, and it shoots video up to an incredible 8K at 30 FPS, a mode that still can't be found on phones from Google or Apple. But they're just numbers at the end of the day. So I'll throw up some real life snaps during a stay at a wildlife retreat last weekend, which made for a beautiful backdrop to test the camera. For starters, the zoom lens is just ridiculously good. Like you can see here in the camera app directly, this is a screen recording, just how close I was able to get to these giraffes at just the 5x and 10x zoom. I did not expect the final photos to look this good. Like, look at this freaking chicken's eye, and also zooming right onto the Sydney Opera House from all the way across the water. The zoom is really, really impressive, and I had so much fun using the incredible zoom, getting in close with animals and capturing super detailed shots I wouldn't usually be able to with my iPhone. The ultra-wide camera also looks amazing in bright light. The two tele lenses add good detail and quality to photos, and basically almost every photo I snapped had pleasant colors and nice contrast right off the phone. The only thing is, in certain situations, sometimes the photos that came out, the colors lean to this weird sort of purple hue, but this is likely something that Samsung can and will fix in future software updates. Shooting portrait mode surprised me too, especially with the 5x lens in bright light. The photos came out vivid, natural, and just generally looks far better than portrait mode on my iPhone 15 Pro. The S24 Ultra does a great job, I think, isolating the subject in this mode without any artificial halo effect that I see on my iPhone. It's pretty clear that the new Snapdragon chip and AI help boost the overall picture quality, and sometimes to the point where images look too processed, but that's not an issue unique to just this phone. It's pretty common with all smartphones these days. Now, this footage you're seeing right now is the 8K 30fps video mode, and it's also shockingly good, as you can probably see. The colors are really accurate and lifelike straight out of the phone, and the details are great without looking overly sharp. It does a really decent job capturing everyday memories or for even sharing to your socials. The only thing I'd fault it in is shooting in harsh lighting creates this color inconsistency and artifacts, whereas my iPhone didn't have that problem. Overall though, this is the best camera I've used on a mobile phone. There is a lot more to go through with this camera, so if you want to see an in-depth comparison and camera test, let me know down in the comments. Moving on to the design of the S24 Ultra. It looks pretty similar to the S23 Ultra, and in fact, even the S22 Ultra, but there are some iterative improvements. Like the iPhone 15 Pro, titanium rails are now used, but the weight of the S24 Ultra is almost still the same as the S23 Ultra at 233 grams or about 8.2 ounces. It does live up to its durability though, with the titanium structure being less flexible than the previous aluminium build. It's a phone that I've been using the last 2-3 weeks, and I haven't worried at all where I'm taking it or if I'll drop it. It's really solid enough to be just fine with most waist level drops. It's no Nokia 3310, but Samsung has done a great job with this build. The new anti-reflective screen is actually even more impressive. It makes me realize just how reflective my iPhone 15 Pro is. It's a noticeable difference when using the phone around bright light sources, especially outdoors under the sun, and I think it's a great quality of life improvement. The 6.8-inch display is absolutely stunning too. It is incredibly sharp, saturated, and such a joy to use and watch content on, especially when the panel now peaks out at 2600 nits, whereas my iPhone peaks at 2000 nits. I've been using this phone under extremely hot and sunny days in the past few weeks, and the display held up really well. A heads up though that the S24 Ultra is capped at 1000 nits technically, with 2600 nits reserved for outdoor viewing and no other way to unlock it. I've watched all sorts of content from YouTube videos to Blue-Eyed Samurai on Netflix, and the art style of that show just absolutely pops on this display. It's a screen that's just a joy to consume content on, and I'd be totally happy sitting on a morning commute watching Netflix on this display. Now there's also a new speaker grille along the bottom, a flatter S Pen cap, and Samsung reverted back to a traditional flat display, which I think is a great fit to its overall design. The only thing that I wish for though is that it came in a smaller S24 Plus form factor for better single hand use, particularly when using it every single day. The performance on this phone is also a highlight, and Qualcomm has hit a home run with its latest processor, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3. It runs everything perfectly fine, and it only ever felt warm in hand when I was outside in direct sunlight capturing video and photos all day, or playing graphically intensive games like Left to Survive. Pair this up with the 12GB of RAM, and it's not surprising that this makes for one powerful mobile phone with enough juice to run all its AI features locally and seamlessly without hiccups. And of course, that big 5000mAh battery is impressive. It gets me through a full day of use with anywhere between 20 to 50% of extra juice left at the end of my day, depending on how heavily I used it. I never went a day where the phone died on me in the middle of the day, so I think it's more than enough for both power and casual users, even if you have a big night out, for example. It's a genuine improvement over the S23 Ultra's smaller 5,565mAh battery, so the S24 Ultra is about a 10% increase in battery size. Plus, I love that there's reverse wireless charging at 7.5 watts, something Apple still hasn't implemented into their iPhones. Connectivity is great too, with Bluetooth 5.3, 5G, and also Wi-Fi 6E speeds that are on par with my iPhone 15. But the S24 Ultra is the first phone to support Wi-Fi 7 types of speeds. I can only imagine the types of speeds it'll reach on a Wi-Fi 7 router, so I'm really keen to get a Wi-Fi 7 capable router to give this a go. Also, let's quickly talk about the S24 Ultra stylus pen for a moment, because coming over from an iPhone, I was like, why would you need a stylus pen? I've got fingers. But you know what? I am enjoying the S Pen more than I thought I would. Photo editing, taking screenshots and writing over it and scribbling quick notes, minus the sounds it makes on the Notes app that seem to annoy my friends. It's a great to have feature that helps separate the S24 Ultra from the rest of the lineup. I also just appreciate how it's nicely integrated into the phone to save us from carrying it around. So the S24 Ultra is excellent across the board. It has amazing performance, a beautiful super bright display, long battery life, and top of the line camera that is second to none. But overall, it's not just a great successor to the S23 Ultra, it's a great phone full stop, and I must say I am really glad I climbed over the walled garden of Apple to see what there is on offer on the other side, because I've been really impressed with this phone. I want to ask those of you who own a Galaxy phone or even have the S24 Ultra over the last few weeks, what do you think about this phone yourself? For me personally, the only thing that's stopping me from completely changing over is the Apple ecosystem. It has a tight grip on my digital life, but what I might do is use the S24 Ultra as my business phone and my iPhone 15 as my personal phone, so I can start to ramp up into the world of Samsung Galaxy phones, because I'm really, really enjoying it. One thing is for sure though, I cannot wait to dive deeper into the world of Android phones this year, because damn, I've been missing out. This is a great top tier phone. If you made it to the end of this video, comment the code word Ultraman and I'll give it a like, and I'll leave a video right here to my iPhone 15 Pro long-term review. As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.